Hi everyone, I'm Ian Harvey, massage therapist, and today I want to talk to you about toxins. The toxins that are coursing through your body and your massage therapist flushes them out, and then you have to drink a lot of water to get rid of the toxins, and none of those things are true. You're not teeming with toxins, and even if you were, we couldn't do anything about it as massage therapists. The first part of this video is for massage clients who have been told about these toxins by their massage therapists. They went to Google to search for massage toxins and hopefully came across this video instead of one of the thousands of scary sites telling you about how toxic you are. You're not. The second part of this video is for massage therapists, so we can get you up to speed about actual science regarding toxins and what we can do as massage therapists, which is very little. If you'd like to skip ahead, click on the table of contents down in the description. So, massage clients, you may have been told by your massage therapist that they had to break up some toxins, kind of wring them out of your muscles and flush them out, and then by drinking a lot of water and taking Epsom salt baths, you're able to get rid of those toxins. That massage is a detoxifying process. But that's based on some misconceptions about how the body works. A common misconception among massage therapists is that massage increases circulation. And this is true on a very short term and at a local level, but everything that you do, this that I'm doing right now, all this gesticulation, is increasing my circulation. It's because circulation is a one-way process. There are arteries that bring blood out to your extremities and veins that bring blood back. And those can only go one way because of a lot of tiny little valves. So every time your heart beats and every time you move a muscle, every time you move in gravity, blood and lymphatic fluid is being returned back toward your core. It's being moved past these lymph nodes. It's being moved to your heart, where it goes to your lungs, to your liver, to your kidneys. And this is where detoxification happens and filtration happens. So if you've got too much of something in your blood, that's going to be taken care of naturally. And any movement you make is going to increase circulation just as well as any massage. If you want to increase your circulation, go on a walk around your living room. The idea that blood can become stagnant in your muscles isn't supported by evidence. The idea that your muscles can become stuck together isn't supported by evidence. As long as you aren't bedbound, as long as you're moving occasionally, and as long as your heart is beating, you're having nice consistent circulation, filtration, and detoxification. And a question might come up in your mind, well, Ian, what about lactic acid? What about lactic acid crystals? And this might be something that your massage therapist told you about, or a nutritionist, or a personal trainer. These are all common myths in these various realms. And these are based on old misconceptions about how lactic acid works. Lactic acid isn't a poison. It's not a waste product, and it's immediately taken up and used by your body. There's no chance for crystals to form in your body, and there's no need for massage therapists to crunch those crystals up. If your massage therapist has found something crunchy in your shoulder, that's not a crystal, that's gristle. That's connective tissue or scar tissue, and there's nothing that we can do to remove that permanent tissue. What we can do as massage therapists is reduce the pain associated with those tight areas, but it's not by breaking down your structure. It's by working with your body and working with your nervous system to reduce the sensitivity of those areas and the tightness of those muscles. Now, why do massage therapists talk about toxins so much and flushing toxins and lactic acid? Well, it's because they're taught it in massage school quite frequently, and they read about it in blogs and they read about it in books, despite the fact that this has been disproven decades ago. So it's what they know, and they're trying to pass on good information to you, but it ends up being kind of scary. You get the idea that your body is just constantly full of toxins. The second reason is that it's an easy explanation for pain. The idea that there are these crystals that we can break up with our hands to relieve pain is a very seductive idea. It's something that makes a lot of immediate sense and lets us think that we can take immediate action. But pain is messy. Pain has to do with the nervous system and with inflammation and with repetitive actions and strains, and it's not easily solvable in a single session, and it requires you to make changes as the client and for your massage therapist to do consistent work over time, not just in a single session. And the third reason is that it lets some massage therapists who like to work very aggressively, it lets them shift blame to you. If you get a very aggressive massage and the next day you feel like you got hit by a truck and you feel tired and maybe a little sick with flu-like symptoms, maybe a hangover kind of, that's not your fault. If that massage therapist tells you that it's because you didn't drink enough water, you should have gotten rid of those toxins, or if they tell you that you should have taken an Epsom salt bath, or that this is just part of the detoxification process, once we get rid of all those toxins, you'll stop having this reaction. But no, if you feel sick, if you feel hurt the day after a massage, it's because you've been injured. It's because that massage therapist has beaten you up over the course of an hour, and that's not okay. And that's not to say that I've never had negative outcomes from giving my massages. I try to meet people at their level of tolerance, but sometimes they have excessive soreness the next day. And my response is, I'm sorry about that. Let's back off this time. And over time, I've decided to err on the side of caution and not be so assertive during my first couple of massages. But if your massage therapist tries to shift that blame onto you, go see somebody else. Go see someone who doesn't blame imaginary toxins, who knows more about human physiology, and who will meet you at your level of physical tolerance. And massage therapists who stuck through all of that, I appreciate you. I know it's not always easy to hear that things that you learned in massage school aren't correct, but the scientific world has moved on, and this idea of lactic acid as the enemy is just no longer thought to be true. So if you're still with me, we're going to talk about what toxins actually are, what biologists actually consider to be toxic, how the body deals with those toxins, and then we're going to kind of rehabilitate lactic acid and realize that it's not the enemy. So toxins do exist. Any chemical in sufficient quantity can be toxic to the body, but some are more toxic than others. The two that come to mind are persistent organic pollutants, and these are things like insecticides and industrial byproducts, and toxic heavy metals, things like lead, cadmium, mercury. And your body deals with these in a few ways as you breathe them in the air. We're constantly breathing in some amount of toxins. As we eat food, we're consuming pesticides, we're consuming heavy metals, and as we drink water, we're taking in varying quantities of toxins. And this depends on where you live in the world. It depends on what kind of food you eat. Different people will have different toxic burdens in their body. But your body is extremely able to deal with these things, thanks to, first of all, the hepatic portal system. Any food or water that you consume, as it is absorbed, its very first stop is the liver. It doesn't get shuttled all around your body first. First stop, it's this big detoxifying organ right here. And what the liver does, it uses enzymes to break down toxins to make them less toxic to the body, or it adds on another compound to make it less toxic, and then you're able to excrete those things. We also get rid of excess amount of dangerous chemicals through our urine. They're filtered out through our kidneys and through our skin. We sweat out a certain amount of toxins. And finally, our bodies do something pretty cool with large amounts of dangerous chemicals to make them less dangerous, which is sequestration. We sequester things like lead in our bones. We sequester certain persistent organic pollutants in our adipose cells, and this keeps them from constantly exposing the rest of our tissues to those compounds, and it allows us to deal with them slowly. And something I'd like you to notice about all of these things, the detoxification, the filtration, the sequestration, is that there's nothing that massage can do to assist with any of these. We can't help the liver work better. We can't help the kidneys work better. We can't break up the bones to release those compounds, even if we wanted to. And that brings us to lactic acid. Lactic acid is not the enemy. That's based on some old thoughts about what lactic acid was, that it was a waste product following anaerobic exercise that had to be flushed from the body, but that's not at all the case. In the body, lactic acid is found as lactate. Lactate is what forms when lactic acid is ionized in a solution. So this lactate in our body isn't a metabolic waste, it's a metabolic intermediary. It's something that is produced during anaerobic respiration and then that is immediately reused. It's either reused locally by converting it back to pyruvate, at which point it can be oxidized again to be used for more energy, or it's shuttled elsewhere to be converted into glucose via gluconeogenesis, and then it can be turned into glycogen. In other words, this is an extremely useful resource, and it's not something that the body just leaves lying around. It's not something that could be left to crystallize in your muscle cells. It's used, or via the pumping of your heart and the muscle pump, it's brought back to your core, and then that conversion happens in your liver, and it's reused. And in fact, this happens extremely quickly. Even after repeated sprinting or anaerobic exercise, your body can bring your lactate levels in your blood back down to its normal level, and there is a normal level of lactate in your blood. It is not the enemy. That happens very quickly, within an hour or 2 hours. You can see a link to a study about that down in the description. So that's my rant about toxins. The reason why I feel strongly about this and why I wish we could stop telling clients things about toxins is because I think that it's stigmatizing. It leads people to think bad things about their own body, that their body is sick and that they need us to make them well. And I think that that's wrong. We can work in partnership with people to help them feel better and to feel more comfortable in their own bodies, but they don't need us to make them less sick. So by all means, I want you to have conversations with clients about the causes of their pain and what they can do to be a partner with you in relieving that pain. But it's okay to be tentative. It's okay to not be completely sure what's causing a phenomenon in the body. And it's definitely okay to discard this old information that hasn't been updated in decades. All right, thanks for watching. Let me know what you want to see next. Let me know what you think down in the comments. Consider subscribing, and I'll see you next time.